more quality minutes from your top players. I think that's been a key for this team as well.
Top line out there. Here is Robertson. Lost it, and his skate somehow found it and put it off the shoulder of Gustafson.
There's some guys on Dallas that can reciprocate what Minnesota wants to do. Hintz is one of those guys. Ben
out in front. That shunted just wide by Matt Zuccarello. Throws one down low. Johansson off the outside of the net. Hit by Hakanpaa. They tumble down behind. And now Spurgeon. Wrist shot. Score! Traffic in front. And the power play strikes first for Minnesota with 47.7 to go in the period.
The other area, the flanks aren't open. And the middle's not open. So get it to the point. And Kaprizov does a good job of timing this shot by Spurgeon as he comes into the screen right there, able to get a stick on it, as Lindell not able to. 1-0 lead, four shots on goal for Kaprizov. Thought he looked awfully comfortable. Dean Evason mentioned to us this morning that, you know, his time off would mean he's well rested. He certainly looked well rested in that first period. If you're Minnesota, you got to make sure you win faceoffs and clear it when you can, because when Dallas sets it up, there's just a lot of problems.
And they set up Hintz, who shoots and scores! Just like that, the power play strikes. Rafe Hintz ties it at one.
First period didn't play out that way, but this is a clean face-off win by Jamie Benn right to Rafe Hintz. And the best chance of the hockey game for Dallas right there on the power play, uncontested for Hintz, and he's able to rip it past the glove of Filip Gustavsson. An important goal for Dallas.
Pavelski and Steele on the draw to the left of Gustafson. One by Pavelski. Haskinen brings it straight away, and now Robertson. Wrist shot. Score! Robertson on the power play. The Stars strike again. 2-1, they lead.
Start this second period. Pavelski clean win. Haskinen gets it over to Robertson, and I think Gustafson has a tough time finding this puck through Jonas Brodin, who is out trying to get in the lane. And you can see Gustafson at the last second look to the left of Brodin, and the shot goes to the right of Brodin. And because of that, Gustafson not able to.
Back to the point, Brodin. Back to Zuccarello. With room down low. Out in front. A block by Ottinger, and he covers it up on the edge of the crease. Floats back to the line. Spurgeon keeps it onside. Johansson to Kaprizov. Saucers out in front. Oh, saved by Ottinger as he robs Zuccarello on the one-timer. The second period is at a completely different feel than the first period. Long shot deflects high and wide. Foligno chops it down in front into the blue paint. And Ottinger searching for it. Kaprizov found it. And the whistle stops play. At 9:30 on ESPN2 in Seattle and Colorado. We'll begin their series tomorrow night at Ball Arena as well. Robertson's shot blocked and a possible break. Here's Sam Steele in on Ottinger. Scores! Tied at two in game one here in Dallas.
Robertson gets high, tries to get the puck to the net. It gets blocked by Sam Steele, and then he takes off from there. And then on the breakaway, able to go backhand, forehand, and elevate. But an important block by Steele in the defensive zone on the forward, Jason Robertson. And then the awareness by Steele to simply take off after that. And Steele does the rest. But make no mistake, Dumba, the hit, it's all done with now. The hope is that Joe Pavelski will be okay.
Fighting with Faber in the trapezoid and frees it up. And now Boldy with a head of steam. Works his way through center. Pitches one ahead. Controlled by Johansson. Moves in. Save made by Ottinger. Johansson at the rebound. Centers one. Behind Gaudreau. Zuccarello further into the corner. Zuccarello pivots. Plays it back up. Straight away Middleton. A one-timer. Save made by Ottinger. He was there to keep it out of the net. Hartman had a great look. Dumped into the offensive zone by Minnesota. And we will need overtime to decide game one of this opening round best of seven between the Wild.
You never know what play can go in. I get the sense we're in for a long night, though, the way this game is settling in.
No 3-on-3, no shootout. Sudden death to decide game one. And we are underway in overtime. And that's chipped to the near wing. Gloved down by Johansson. Tape to tape, Freddie Gaudreau with some speed towards the net. Boldy! Save made by Ottinger on the follow with the glove! He flashes leather, and we play on.
Two huge saves so far for Ottinger in this overtime. The latest on Marcus Johansson. Once this puck hits Ottinger's pads, he's out of position, but that glove just stretches out, and look at the reaction on the Minnesota bench.
Sagan, and behind the net. Dropped off to a moving Roope Hintz. Hintz in the high slot. Wrist shot blocked in front. The rebound loose. Digging for it is Sagan. And he gets wiped out by Ryan Reeves, allowing Gustafson to cover the puck. The first overtime. Overtime number two underway. And here's Dadonov going to work behind the net. Looks to put it out in front. Off the outside of the post. Snapped by Johnston. Out to the red line. Past Sagan. Broken up by Dumba. With some speed, Gaudreau to his right to Boldy. Boldy, backhander off the pad of Ottinger.
Gassed. They're having difficulty just getting to the red line.
Here's Hartman. Accelerates. Save made by Ottinger, and he has no idea where the puck is. And it went off his shoulder into the netting. Johansson and Sagan in the right wing corner. Robertson digs in as well. Johansson comes away with the puck. Possible numbers through center, an odd man rush. Gaudreau across the line, flips it back door. Save made by Ottinger! He kicked out the left pad, and for the second time in overtime, he robbed Johansson.
As I mentioned, hard to get chances in the last little bit, but when they do get the quality chance, Ottinger has the answer. Marcus Johansson not able to elevate this puck, and
by the pinching Harley, and that's wrapped all the way around to Gus Nyquist. He wheels and deals center circle. Off to Steele. Harley pokes that pass to the corner. It ends up right out in front. Shot! Score! It's over! And who does it but Hartman? Fought through injury all night, and he gets the game winner! What a road win in overtime for Minnesota in game one!
Kill for Minnesota. They hung on the ropes for most of the overtime periods. This puck squirts out in front, and the advantage of being on your forehand for Hartman allows him to be patient here. It's just easier for a player when he's on his forehand to wait out the goaltender and get to an area where you can find the net. Incredible patience for Hartman. The puck squirted out to him.